Boathouse pros and cons. Boathouse for sale offer came out of the blue. I had considered buying a houseboat in the past, but no, I had an offer on the table to buy one. So I'm sorting the boathouse pros cons to see if I should buy it. There are many pros and cons of living on a floating home, so I have done some research and found the most common ones and ones that will apply to my case. So now on to the pros and cons of buying a boathouse. There are lots of pros and lots of cons about acquiring the boathouse, so I'm going to list them below. I'm going to list the pros first. If I miss any, please do let me know. Owning boathouse pros advantages. Number 1, fish anytime. You can fish anytime you wish. Of course, this one has to be number 1. Morning or night. Early in the evenings or right before sunset. Can't sleep, it's 3 a.m., no worries, go fishing. Woke up early, have an extra half an hour to kill. Guess what? You can go fishing anytime in your houseboat. Number 2, awesome scenery. Waking up every morning to the sounds of the river. Hearing the fish jump in the water. That cool, refreshing morning mist that comes up early in the morning. Seeing an otter on its morning swim. Watching a sunrise from your fishing deck while enjoying a cup of coffee. These are some things that I could enjoy if I decide to buy and live in a boathouse of my own. Number 3, vacation activities all year round. Most people get to enjoy the water on the occasional weekend that they make it to their local river, lake or beach. By me living on this boathouse, I will have unparalleled access to vacation activities every day of the week. Activities like boating, tubing, swimming, water skiing and of course fishing. Number 4, no yard to take care of on a houseboat. On a boathouse there is no grass to mow, no weeds to pull, no snow to shovel and no sprinklers to fix. Get some potted plants if you want to have some greenery to take care of, or not. This is your choice. Personally, the view right outside my window would be enough greenery for me. And the best part is that I would not have to take care of it. Number 5, the houseboat will be an upgrade. My current living space is 60 square feet. This houseboat is 12 feet wide by 40 feet long. That is 480 square feet of living space that I could enjoy. That's 8x the amount of living space I currently have. I think that will give me some elbow room and a place to fish every day at the same time. Those are definite pros of owning a boathouse. Number 6, no property taxes. Your houseboat may be classified as a pleasure vehicle that happens to have a house on top of it. So depending on your state and county where the houseboat is registered, there will probably be no property taxes. Simply pay DMV for your houseboat tags and that's it. I would guess that this would be a lot cheaper than property taxes any day of the week. Number 7, houseboat tax break. It is definitely possible to get a tax break from your houseboat. It would depend on many variables like, is this your only home? Does it have all the amenities required to be considered a home? Cooking, sleeping, and toilet facilities all on board. Will you work out of your houseboat? And many other variables. I'm not a lawyer, a tax person, or an accountant, so I would recommend that you ask one of them first before you try to add your houseboat to your taxes. Number 8, rent would be cheaper than a normal house. I know. I said I was buying the boathouse, and yes, hopefully, fingers crossed, I will be able to buy it. What I mean by rent are the dock fees that have to be paid every month in order to keep the boathouse anchored in the marina. So I'm renting a space, but the boat would be paid for. Number 9, utilities on a houseboat should not be much. Trying to cool down or heat up a 480 square feet space would not take very much power. So the electricity bill should not be very much. There is no gas bill. Sewer and garbage are included on the dock fees. So really truly, if I go crazy and run the AC all day and all night then, and maybe then my electricity bill would go through the roof. But if I only use the AC on the hottest part of the day, it should be fine. Number 10, I can improve the boathouse. Being my personal property and my house, I would and can make some upgrades to the boathouse. Two things come to mind. A bigger window on one wall for a bigger panoramic view of the river. And installing a solar panel system. Each of this I can do on my own and save money on electricity on one and get a better view on the other. Number 11, the boathouse is in the water. The boathouse is in the water is a pro in itself. I like to go fishing, I love nature and I like that it will be my own boathouse that is in the water. No need to travel anywhere to go fishing. Buying boathouse cons, disadvantages. Here are some of the cons of buying and living in a boathouse. There are a few disadvantages of houseboat living that you should be aware of before you decide to buy one, and I'm listing some below. If I miss any, please do let me know in the comments below. Number 1. Mosquitoes and bugs. This is the first thing I think when living on the boathouse, right next to the water and all that nature. There will be lots of mosquitoes and bugs at night. Not to mention all the other night creatures that you will find living by the river. Number 2. Watch out for homeowners associations. Some marinas have a homeowners association that can dictate what you can and cannot do with your own boathouse. Not to mention they all charge a monthly fee for the right to tell you what you can and can't do with your boathouse. Kinda of a wraparound problem here. In my case, there is not this problem. But if you are considering buying the boathouse, make sure you ask if there is an WA. Number 3. Additional fees to live in a houseboat. Is it cheaper to live on a houseboat? Well, that really all depends on a few things. Do you have payments, interest fees, slip fees, and many other things to consider? There is not a one-size-fits-all answer, so the best I can do on my case is figure out what on average it will cost me to run the houseboat. There are some additional costs to owning a houseboat that you should be aware of. Some may or may not apply to your case. Boat payment, if you finance it, there are slip or dock fees that you would have to pay. And WA fee if there is one. Gas fees in the form of propane tanks for cooking. Fuel if you are planning on moving the boathouse anywhere. Dumping fees for sewer are an additional charge in some marinas. The boathouse maintenance. Being in the water, you have to make sure everything is fixed promptly. Number 4. Living in small spaces. A regular boathouse has much less living space than a regular single-family home. This particular boathouse is 12 feet by 40 feet, with 12 feet by 30 feet of living space, so livable space is only 360 square feet. This is about the size of a small studio. So if you need to have a big living room, a spacious kitchen and a roomy bedroom, this is not the place for you. For me, it's perfect. I do not require a lot of room, I own very little, and I'm very content to live in very little space. Number 5. Storage space will be hard. There is no basement, no attic, no garage. The space you have is the space you got. Storage space will be hard to figure out at first. But since I own very little, I can accommodate and organize as I get things as I get them. If there is no room for it, I guess I will not have it. Number 6. Parking and walking. The marina sits 20 feet from the main road. I have to park my vehicle on the main road, then walk down the ramp to get to the boathouse. Well, you have to consider your vehicle safety and having to carry everything from the car to the boathouse and vice versa. Number 7. Neighbors are close by. Unlike a regular house where your neighbor is on the other side of the fence and about 8 to 10 feet away from you on a track home anyways, your boathouse neighbor is literally 4 feet away with no fence to separate you. So it may be too close for comfort, and sometimes privacy may be an issue. Number 8. Lively boathouse neighborhood. Some marinas can be more lively than others, and it may not be as quiet as you would like it to be. If possible, I'm considering renting the boathouse to see the actual neighborhood and how things are. Don't know if it will be possible, but I can ask. Number 9. Bathroom on a houseboat is small. Being a small boathouse, the bathroom is small as well. I want to say that it is about the size of two porta potties side by side. One side is the small shower and the other side is the toilet portion. That is not a very big space. Number 10. The boathouse is in the water. This one is an advantage and a disadvantage of living in a houseboat. The house is in the water, so you have to deal with the swaying of the river, the ups and downs of the tide. Nature in itself will try to destroy it. Expect to be shifted and moved around a bit on a storm. The power may go out during a thunderstorm. And getting wet on your way to your car during the rain will be a certainty.